हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज़ प्रोफेसर मोहम्मद आसिम एंड वी आर डूइंग एडमैस कोर्स. व्हाट आई टोल्ड यू इन लास्ट लेक्चर, दोज स्टूडेंट्स हु बिलोंग्स टू IGCSE बोर्ड विच हैव कोर्स नंबर इज 0606 एंड ऑल दोज स्टूडेंट्स हु आर ओ लेवल विच हैव कोर्स नंबर 4037 कैन गेट बेनिफिट फ्रॉम दिस कोर्स. The syllabus is same for both IGCSE and O level. In last lecture, we started chapter number 1, name is function, and we have completed exercise 1.1. So those students who didn't attend last lecture, kindly go to my playlist and see the AdMath folder where you have find the exercise 1.1, and you can get concept, all those concepts which are related to exercise 1.1. Okay students, so we are going to start exercise 1.2 of the same chapter number 1, function. Before I start exercise 1.1, I want to give you the concept of this exercise. First, we have to learn about the definition of a function. In last lecture, we did definition of mapping, and today we are going to understand the definition of a function. There is a very small difference between mapping and a function, which I will tell you after few minutes. First, have a look the definition of a function. A function is a rule that maps each x value to just one y value for a defined set of input values. A function is a rule that maps each x value to just one y value for a defined set of input values. Students, we have learned in last lecture three kind of mapping: one-one mapping, many-one, and one-many. What is the meaning of one-one mapping? For one input value, there is just one output value. What does it mean? It means, for example, if we have a function like x is mapped onto x plus 1, for example. If I take some values, some random values of x like 1, 2, 3, if I put x1 in this output box, so if we put 1 over here, we will get 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. If we put 2 over here, so 2 plus 1 is 3. If we put 3 over here, so 3 plus 1 is 4. So if we put one value of x and we get one value of y, this is y actually. This is x. How to read this? I told you in last lecture, x is mapped to x plus 1, and another way to writing this is fx is equals to x plus 1. X maps to x plus 1, or fx is equals to x plus 1, both are same. You know, fx, function of x, this is called function of x. Fx is always equals to y. So this x maps to x plus 1, or you can write fx is equals to x plus 1, or you can write y is equals to x plus 1. Now come to the definition of function. What is the definition of function? A function is a rule that maps each x value to just one y value for a defined set of input values. So see this, for just one input value, I took three values of x, random value, you can take any other values, 1, 2, 3. And if I put x over here, I will get 2. If I put 2 over here, I will get 3. If I get 3 over here, I will get 4. So for the values of x, 1, 2, 3, we got values of y, what? 2, 3, 4. Now see the definition of function again. A function is a rule that maps each x value to just one y value. So this shows if this is a function, then there should be one value of y for just one value of x. Okay, student? So we can say that this is a function because it fulfill the requirement of function. And obviously this is the kind of 1-1 mapping. 1-1 mapping is what? For just one input value, we get one output value. So this is the function. Okay. Now so this is the 1-1 mapping, and this 1-1 mapping fulfill the requirement of the definition of function. Second kind of mapping, which we have learned in last lecture, is many-one. What does it mean? For two input values, there is one output value. What does it mean? Suppose that we have a function y is equals to x square. Suppose that we have an equation y is equals to x square. Now check, is this a function or not? Is a function or not a function? Question mark. Suppose that if I take two values of x, like 2 and minus 2, and if I put 2 over here, so 2 square is 4, and if I put minus 2 over here, I am getting minus 2 square is again 4. So this is the kind of mapping. What is the mapping? Name is many-one mapping. We have already learned in exercise 1.1. Is this a function or not? Yes, because for two input values, there is one output value. For 2, we are getting 4. For minus 2, we are getting 4. So for two input value, we are getting one output value. So this is a function. So what is what is the definition of function? A function is a rule that maps each x value to just one y value for a defined set of input values. So we are able to say that two kind of mapping. Number one, 1-1. What is 1-1 mapping? For one input value, there should be one output value. So this is 1-1 mapping is always a function. The second one is many-one. Many-one mapping is also a function. You can see this. Y is equals to x square is a function or not? So for two input values, there is one output value. So the criteria of function is y value should be 1, not more than 1. If y value is more than 1, then this is not a function. Now, third kind of mapping. see the third kind of mapping which we have learned in our last lecture. Suppose that we have a function y is equals to plus minus square root of x. Suppose that our input value is 1. So if I put 1 instead of x, 1 root 1 plus minus, what is the square root of 1? Square root of 1 is 1. So two values of y, 1 and minus 1. Is this a function? Is this a function or not? Answer is no. This is not a function, because the definition of function is for one value of x or more than one value of x, y value should be 1. But in this case, we are seeing that for one value of x, there are two values of y. So this is third kind of mapping, and it is called one many. Wait. So one mapping is a function. Many one mapping is also a function, because it gives only one value y. And third kind, one to many, is not a function, because it gives more than one value of y, not a function. See this. This is the kind of one many function. For one input value, there are two output values. So this is not a function. This is one input value and one output value. This is called one mapping. And this is a function, and you may also call this is a one function instead of one mapping. See this. This is many one. Many one means for two input values there is one output value, or for two x value you can say there is one y value. So this is also a function, because it is fulfilled the criteria, and you can call many one mapping, or you may say many one function. And this one many mapping, and this is not a function, because it gives two values of y. I hope you completely understand the definition of function. So I am reading again. A function is a rule that maps each x value to just one y value for a defined set of input values. This means that mapping that are either one or many one are called function. I already told you, the mapping x maps to x plus 1, where x belongs to a real number, means x can take any value, is a one function. Yes, you can call it one mapping or one function. It can be written as f colon x map to x plus 1, or you can write simply fx is equals to x plus 1, or you can write y is equals to x plus 1. Keep in mind, fx is always equals to y. So you can write fx or is equals to x plus 1, or you can write y is equals to x plus 1. So how to read this is, read the function f is such that x is mapped to x plus 1, or shortly you can say this is fx is equals to f of x is equals to x plus 1. Fx represent the output values for the function. Yes, keep in mind, fx, x means x is always input values, and fx is always fx or y is always represent output values. Hope you understand. Now, so fx represent the output values for the function f. So when fx is equals to x plus 1, then f2 is equals to 2 plus 1, 3. Yes. Suppose that fx is equals to f x is equals to x plus 1, then f of 2 means we have to put 2 where we see x. So f x is equals to x plus 1, so f of 2 is 2 plus 1 and 2 plus 1 is 3. So the value of function when x is equals to 2 is 3. Okay. The set of input values for a function is called the domain of the function. This is very important. We are learning domain and range of a function. The set of input values for a function is called the domain of a function. See this. For example, suppose that we have a function fx is equals to x plus 3. So if I put x is equals to 1, 2, 3, for example, so if we put 1, we will get 1 plus 3, 1 plus 3 is 4. If we put 2 in the function, we will get 2 plus 3 is 5. If we put 3 in the function, we will get 3 plus 3 is 6. So what is the definition of domain? See again, the set of input values for a function is called the domain. What we have put in this situation, we put x is equals to 1, 2, 3. So this set of value is called the domain of a function. Whatever you are putting in a function formula or in a function rule, it is called a domain. Okay, students. Now come to the second definition called range. What is the definition of range? The set of output values for a function is called the range or image. What we have our output in this situation, our output is 4, 5 and 6. So this 4, 5 and 6 is range, or you may call it image, both are same. Okay, student. So I repeat again, domain is the input value, set of input value, and range is the set of output values. So for this formula, fx is equals to x plus 3, our domain is 1, 2, 3, and for this domain 1, 2, 3, our range is 4, 5, 6. Range or image, both are same. Now we have done the definition of function, and we have learned the definition of domain of a function and range or image of a function. Now see the work example. The work example is fx is equals to 2x minus 1. X belongs to R. X belongs to R, or x in R. What is this? X can take any value, and the restricted value of x is from minus 1 to 3. You can read this minus 1 less than equals to x less than equals to 3, or you can read this x is greater than equals to minus 1 less than equals to 3, or you can read the values of x from minus 1 to 3. Question part A, write down the domain of the function. So what we have learned, what is the domain? Domain is the input value. So obviously the domain of this function is from minus 1 to 3, because these are the input values. Hope you understand. So the answer of part A is the domain is minus 1 to 3. Part B, sketch the graph of the function f. So I want to show you the graph. what is our function? Fx is equals to 2x minus 1. Fx is equals to 2x minus 1, and x from minus 1 to x from minus 1 to 3, x from minus 1 to 3. We have to sketch, we have to plot this. It's very easy to plot this. This is fx. First you have to write this y, because fx and y both are same. Student, you have learned in coordinate geometry in math that this is the equation of straight line. This is the equation of straight line. So how to sketch the graph of this straight line? First, check the y-intercept. What is y-intercept? If you compare this, the general equation of the straight line, y is equals to mx plus c. C is the y-intercept. So in this equation, y-intercept is minus 1. So you can call this, for example, minus 1. And the gradient is 2. Gradient represented by small m. So gradient is 2. So the sketch of this graph is, see this. If we put minus 1 in this equation, we will get 2 into minus 1, minus 2, minus 2, minus 1 is minus 3. And if we put x is 3 in the given equation, 2, 3 is a 6, 6 minus 1 is 5. So we have two sets of values, x is minus 1, minus 3, x is minus 1. You can write 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. This is just a rough graph. And the second is, when x is 3, then y is 5. One, two, three. Y is 5. And when x is minus 1, then y is minus 3. Y is minus 3. Okay, I am drawing again. X, y. What are the values? Two set of values, minus 1 and minus 3. So x is minus 1 and y is minus 3. And the second is x is 3, y is 5. So x is 3. 1, 2, 3. Y is 5. So these are two sets of value. One is 3, 5, and other is minus 1 and minus 3. And then plot the straight line. This is our straight line. See this more accurate. So this is the answer of part B, sketch the graph of a function. So how to sketch the graph of the given? Just take the domain or x values and put all x values in the given function equation, fx is equals to 2x minus 1, and then sketch the graph. What is the third part? Third part is write down the range of a function. So what is the definition of range? What I put it in the given formula, minus 1, in the given formula we got minus 3. And x is equals to 3, when we put x is equals to 3 in the formula, we got 5. So the range is fx is greater than equals to minus 3, less than equals to 5. See this. How to write the range? This is x is always the domain, x is always the domain, and range is fx minus 3 to 5. So whenever you see fx with inequality sign, it means this is the range. Okay, so this is work example number 1. See work example number 2. The function f is defined by fx is equals to x minus 2 whole square plus 3 for x is from 0 to 6. So obviously x 0 to 6 is the domain of a function. What is the question? Sketch the graph of the function and find the range of f. How to sketch this graph? It's very easy. This is a quadratic function, so the graph will be of the form of parabolic shape. Okay, whenever you see the graph of this kind, x square plus 2 or x square minus 2 or x minus 2 whole square and so on, the graph is always a parabola. Okay, this shape is called a parabola. So parabolic shape we will obtain if the graph is quadratic. Quadratic means the highest power is 2. So fx is equals to x minus 2 whole square plus 3 is a positive quadratic function. So the graph will be of the form of the parabola. So x minus 2 whole square plus 3, this part of the expression is a square, so it will always be greater than equals to 0, or you can say greater or you can say positive. So x minus 2, this is our work example, y is equals to x minus 2 whole square plus 3. Whatever you put in this equation, you always get positive value, because if the power is even means like 2, 4, 6, the answer is always positive. So this is the meaning of this line. This part of the expression is a square, so it will always be positive. Greater than means positive, or equals to means can be equal to 0. The smallest value it can be is 0. This occurs when x is equals to 2. Obviously our domain is from 0 to 6, so 0 1 2 3 4 5 6. So if we put 2 over here, we will get 2 minus 2 is 0, 0 square 0, 0 plus 3 is 3. So the minimum value of the function is 3, because if we put other than 2, we always get the whole value greater than equals to 3. So what is this? The minimum value of the expression is 0 plus 3, 3, and this minimum occur when x is equals to 2. So the function fx is equals to x minus 2 whole square plus 3 will have a minimum point at 2, 3. 2, 3 means the value of x is 2 and the value of y is 3. See this graph carefully. This is 2, x 2 and y 3. X is a horizontal line and y is vertical line. This is 2, 3, and other values are put 0 in the given formula. 0 minus 2 is minus 2, minus 2 squared is plus 4, plus 4 plus 3 is 7, and now put 6 in the given equation. 6 minus 2 is 4, 4 square is 16, 16 plus 3 is 19. So when x is 0, then y is 7, and when x is 6, the y is 19. Join all three points. So this question tells us that when we draw the graph, quadratic graph, we need three coordinates or three points. First is y-intercept, the second one is minimum or maximum point, and the third one. So, but we must find the minimum or maximum point by putting the value of x so that the whole square term is 0. Now, what we put? This is our domain. When we put 0 in the equation, the answer is 7. When we put 6 in the equation, the answer is 19. Therefore, the answer of part this, find the range of f is from 3 to 19, because the minimum value is 3. If you write the minimum value is 7, your answer will consider to be a wrong answer, because the smallest value, range means from smallest value to highest value. If we put this 0 in the equation, we will get 3. Okay, and if we put 0 in the equation, we will get 4 square and plus 3, we will get 7. And if we put 6 in the equation, we will get 19. So if we say our range is from 7 to 19, it will be wrong, because when we put 2 in the equation, the answer is 3. Therefore, our range means from starting end to end values of output values starting to end. So our starting is not 7, our starting is 3. Therefore, the range is range of the function is from 3 to 19. Please keep in mind, this point is very important. Now, after the whole discussion, we are able to exercise 1.2. What is exercise 1.2? Very easy exercise. We will do all questions. Question number 1. Which of the mapping in exercise 1.1 are functions? The requirement is find the function from exercise 1.1. So I am opening exercise 1.1. This is exercise 1.1. So we have already learned in today's class all 1-1 function, all 1-1 mapping or many 1 mapping are always functions, and all kind of 1-many mapping are not a function. See this x plus 1. So, if this one is, we have already done in last lecture, what kind of mapping is this? This is 1-1 mapping, therefore, this is the function. Question 2 was related to many-one mapping, so this is also the function. Question number 3 was 1-1 mapping. Student, please keep in mind, we have done this exercise in last class. Kindly go to my playlist and see the add math folder in order to understand completely. So question number 3 is 1-1 mapping, it is also the function. Question number 4 is 1-1 mapping, it is also the function. Question number 5 is 1-1 mapping, it is also a function. Question number 6 is a 1-1 mapping, it is also a function. Question number 7 is 1-1 mapping, it is also a function. Question number 8 is what? 1-many mapping. So it is not a function. So all questions from 1 to 7 are functions, and 8 is not a function. So what is the question of exercise 1.2? Which of the mapping in exercise 1.1 are function? So the answer of question number 1 exercise 1.2 question number one. So from question number one to question number seven are function, and question number eight is not a function. So this is the answer of question number one. Okay, students, I hope you understand. Now come to question number two. Part A. What is question number two? Find the range for each of these functions. What is the function? Fx is equals to x minus 5 from minus 2 to 7. Fx is equals to x minus 5, and the values of x are minus 2 to 7. Minus 2 to 7. What is the range of this function? Simply put the value of x from minus 2 and 7 in the function. So f of x is x minus 5. We have to put minus 2. Minus 2 minus 5 is minus 7. Now put the value of x is 7. X is 7. So f of 7 is 7 minus 5. 7 minus 5 is what? 2. Therefore, our range is, how to write range? Fx. Fx means range, and only x means domain. So our answer is from, what is the minimum value? Minus 7. So it should be greater than equals to minus 7. What is the maximum value? 2. So this is the answer of part A. Hope you understand. See part B. Part B is fx is equals to 3x plus 2. Part B is fx is equals to 3x plus 2. And what is the domain given from 0 to 5? From 0 to 5. Just put starting value in the given formula and ending value in the given formula. But keep in mind, if the function is quadratic, quadratic means where the highest power is 2, then we will do some special work in order to find the range. But these are just equations of straight line. So we just put starting and ending value. So I am putting directly f of 0 means 3 into 0. 3 into 0 is 0. 0 plus 2 is 2. Now put 5 in the given equation. F of 5. 3, 5 is 15 plus 2 is 17. So our range is from 2 to 17. This is the answer of part B. Hope you understand. Now we are doing some more parts. Come to part C. What is part C? Fx is equals to 7 minus 2x. Fx part C is fx is equals to 7 minus 2x, and the domain of this part is given minus 1 to 4. X is minus 1 to 4. So simply this is the straight line. So we just put starting value f of minus 1, 7 minus 2 into minus 1, 7 minus minus plus, 2 1s are 2, 7 plus 2 is 9, and put f of 4. So just put 7 minus 2 into 4, 7 minus 2 4s are 8, 7 minus 8 is minus 1. So the answer of part C is fx, what is the minimum value? Minimum value is minus 1, and what is the maximum value? Maximum value is 9. So the answer of part C is from minus 1 to 9. This is our answer. Come to part D. What is part D? Part D is fx is equals to x square. Fx is equals to x square, and the domain is minus 3 to 3. Domain is minus 3 to, from minus 3 to 3. Student, if I put minus 3 in this equation, if I put minus 3 in this, I will get 9. If I put 3 in this equation, I will get again 9. So this is not the range. We have to put many values, because please keep in mind, this is a quadratic function. So don't put just starting and ending values, otherwise the answer will be wrong. Okay, so minus 3, we put minus 3, we will get 9. When we put minus 3, after minus 3 is minus 2. When we put minus 2, we will get 4. When we put minus 1, minus 1 square is 1. And when we put 0, we will get 0. Therefore, our range must be from minimum value is what? 0, and the maximum value is 9. So from 0 to 9 is our answer. Hope you understand. So be careful whenever you see a quadratic function. But if you see a straight line, just put starting and final value. Okay. Question number 2, part E. What is part E? Fx is equals to 2 power x. Fx is equals to 2 power x. And the domain given, minus 3 to 3. Put minus 3 in the given equation. Minus 3, 2 power minus 3. 2 power minus 3 can be write 1 upon 2 power 3. 1 upon 2 power 3 is 8. Now put the ending value, 3 in the equation. 2 power 3, 2 power 3 is 8. Obviously, the minimum value is 1 upon 8 and the maximum value is 8. Therefore, our range is from 1 upon 8 to 8. This is our final answer. Hope you understand. See the last part, F. What is part F? Fx is equals to 1 upon x. Fx is equals to 1 upon x, and the domain is given from 1 to 5. From 1 to 5. X is given from 1 to 5. Simply put, x is equals to 1, we will get 1 upon 1, 1 upon 1 is 1, Now put 5 in the given equation, 1 upon 5, 1 upon 5 is 1 upon 5, no change. Therefore, our range is from 1 upon 5, because this is the smallest value. There is no value which is less than 1 upon 5 in the given situation, and this is the maximum value. So this is our answer. So student, hope you understand all parts of question number 2. See question number 3. I hope you completely understand the concept of domain and range of a function. Sorry for this, takes time. So we are doing exercise 1.2. Now see question number 3. The function g is defined by gx is equals to x square plus 2. Gx is equals to x square plus 2, and domain is for all x greater than equals to 0. Greater than equals to 0 means all positive values including 0. So what should be the range? Student, if we put 0 in the equation instead of x, so 0 square is 0, 0 plus 2 is 2. Therefore, the answer is 2. If I put, because we have restricted to put all values which are greater than 0. So we must put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If I put 1 over here, so 1 square is 1, 1 plus 2 is 3. If I put 2 over here, 2 square is 4, 4 plus 2 is 6. If I put 3 over here, 3 square is 9, 9 plus 2, 11. So if you see carefully, all values starting from 2 and end up to 3, 6, 11 and so on. Therefore, our range must be greater than or equals to 2, because when I put 0, I get 2. When I put greater than 0, I get the value greater than 2. So our range must be greater than or equal to 2. Hope you understand. Now see question number 4. The function f is defined by fx is equals to x square minus 4. Fx is equals to x square minus 4, and the domain is given x in R means x belongs to a real number. So it means x can take any value. Any value means you can take all values, negative values, positive values, fraction value and so on. So what should be the minimum value? If I put 0 over here, I get minus 4. And if I put any value instead of 0, I always get the value which is greater than minus 4. Therefore, our range must be greater than equals to minus 4. This is our answer. Hope you understand. Come to question number 5. Question number 5 is, the function f is defined by fx is equals to x minus 1 whole square plus 5. X minus 1 whole square plus 5, and the domain is x is greater than equals to 1. Clearly, the range must be greater than equals to 5, because if we put any value which is equals to 1 or greater than 1, we always get the value of 5 or greater than 5. Therefore, the range should be greater than equals to 5. This is the answer of question number 5. Okay, see question number 6. What is question number 6? The function fx is defined by fx is equals to 2x plus 1 whole square. Fx is equals to 2x plus 1 whole square, and the domain is given. X is 2x plus 1 whole square minus 5. Sorry, I forgot to write minus 5. And x is greater than equals to minus 1 upon 2. X is greater than equals to minus 1 upon 2. So again, if we put minus 1 upon 2 over here, 2 into minus 1 upon 2 plus 1 whole square minus 5, 2 cancel by this 2, minus 1 plus 1 whole square minus 5, minus 1 cancel by minus 1, 0, 0 square is 0, 0 minus 5 is minus 5. So if we put the value minus 1 upon 2 or greater than minus 1 upon 2, so our range should be greater than or equal to minus 5. Hope you completely understand this question number 6. Now, come to question number 7. Question number 7 is, the function f is defined by fx is equals to 10 minus x minus 3 whole square. Fx is equals to 10 minus x minus 3 whole square. And x is given from 2 to 7. What should be the range? What is the range of this function? Student, if you put 2 in the given equation, so 2 minus 3 is minus 1, minus 1 square is 1, 10 minus 1 is 9. If we put 1 in the given equation, we will get 1 minus 3, 1 minus 3 is minus 2, minus 2 square is 4, and 10 minus 4 is 6. If we put 3 in the given equation, we will get 3 minus 3 is 0, the answer is 10. So it means the range should be less than equals to 10. It means the value is of the value of fx is 10 or less than 10. You can check by putting all values from 2 to 7. Okay. Last question of exercise. The function f is defined by fx is equals to 3 plus square root x minus 2. Question number 8. Fx is equals to what? 3 plus x minus 2. 3 plus x minus 2 square root, for x is greater than equals to 2. what should be the range. It is very easy. If you put 2 in the given formula, 3 plus 2 minus 2, 2 cancelled by 2, 0, 3 plus 0 is 3, and because the domain is greater than or equal to 2, so we are restricted the value of 2 or greater than 2. So our answer is fx should be greater than equals to 3. So this is the last question of exercise 1.2. This is our final answer. Hope you understand. So we have done all questions of exercise 1.2 today with concept of function and domain and range. Hope you understand today's class. Our next class will be consist of the other kind of function called composite function, and we will do after the concept we will do exercise 1.3. Student, if you like my class, kindly do subscribe my channel, share my videos and like my videos and share my videos to your fellows and like my videos. So okay student, good luck for next class.